We are going to start a demo of piezo-resistive pressure sensor. This piezo-resistive pressure sensor is having a plane geometry, but it is actually a 3D model. However, we will not be doing the modeling of the entire structure. Instead, what we are going to do is we are going to observe this model from COMSOL website, that is in the COMSOL portal. If you check piezo-resistive_pressure_sensor, you will be getting some of the demo examples. Right now, let me begin by starting this model. Go to file, go to open. In this, where we have saved our demo files, we are going to locate there. We have actually saved it in one folder called piezo resist pressure. In this, there are certain experiments for which we need to observe the model. Next, what we are going to do is, we are going to begin with the model builder. So, let us start a new COMSOL experiment, and in the new experiment click on model wizard, and in the model wizard choose 3D. From the select physics, we will go into structural mechanics, electromagnetics. And in that we'll choose piezo resistivity and piezo resistivity boundary currents. And then add this. After we have added this, we'll see in the study section, we're going to do a stationary study. Then we are going to observe the geometry. So if you go into geometry, right, so if you go here, select it as micrometer, right, and then we will click on the insert sequence, and in that let us go into our folder. And in this, we'll check piezo-resistive pressure_pressure_sensor_geometric_sequence. Right? So, this is the one. So, this is not the shell sequence. This is the geometric sequence. Click explicit. So in this settings, type piezo resistor in the label text field. Locate the input entity section. From the geometric entity level, select a boundary. And select boundary 46 only. Now, in the definitions toolbar, click explicit. And in the settings window for explicit, type connections. and locate the input entity section from the geometric entity level. Choose boundary. Select the boundaries 1422. In the definitions toolbar, click box. In the settings for box, type membrane, bracket of lower surface. Locate the geometric entity level from the level, choose boundary. In the box limit section, in the X minimum, type field minus 501. In the X maximum, type 501. In the Y min, type minus 30. In the Y max, type 1000. Now type in Z maximum minus 1. Locate the output entity section from the include entity if list. Choose entity inside a box. Now in the membrane, right click membrane lower surface and choose duplicate. In the settings for the box, type membrane upper surface. Now locate the box limit section. In the Z minimum, text field type minus 1. In the Z maximum, text field type infinity. In the definitions toolbar, click box. In the settings window for box, type lower surface in the label. Now from locate the geometric entity level list and in that choose boundary. Locate the box limit section in the Z maximum text. Type minus 1. Locate the output entity section from the include entity. If list, choose entity inside box. Right click the lower surface and choose duplicate. Now change the heading to upper surface. Now locate the box limit section in the Z minimum text field type minus 1. In the Z maximum type inf. In the definitions toolbar, click difference. In the settings window for difference, type fixed in the label. In locate the geometric entity level section from the level, choose boundary. Locate the input entity section under selections to add, click add. In the add dialog box, select lower surface. In the settings window for difference, locate the input entity selection. under the selections to subtract click add. In the add dialog box, select membrane lower surface. In the definitions toolbar, click union. Type electric currents in the label. Then in the geometric entity level, choose boundary. Locate the input entities under selections to and click add. In the add dialog box selection, choose piezo resistor and connections. In the definitions toolbar, click coordinate systems. And choose rotated system. In the settings window for rotated system, locate the rotation section, find the Euler angle Z, X, Z subsection. In the alpha text field, type minus 45 degree. In the home toolbar, click add material to open the add material window. Then in the tree, select piezo resistivity in silicon. This N silicon is a single crystal lightly doped. Click on add to component. Then in the tree, select piezo resistivity P silicon single crystal lightly doped. Again click add to material. Now in the home toolbar, click add material to close the add material window. Now in the settings window for material, locate the geometric entity selection. Here from the geometric entity level, choose boundary. From the selection list, choose electric currents. Solid mechanics. In the model builder window under component 1 solid mechanics, click linear elastic material 1. In the settings window for linear elastic material, locate the coordinate system selection section. From the coordinate system list, choose rotated system 2. Locate the linear elastic material section. From the solid model list, choose anisotropic. From the material data ordering list, choose YOIGT. In the physics toolbar, click boundaries and choose fixed constraint. In the settings for fixed constraint, locate a boundary selection section. From the selection list, choose fixed. In the physics toolbar, click boundaries and choose boundary load. In the settings for boundary load, locate the boundary selection section and in the selection list choose membrane upper surface. Locate the force section from the load type list to choose pressure. In the PTEX field type 100 bracket of KPA. In the model builder window under component 1 click electric currents single layer shell ECS. In the settings window for electric current single layer shell locate the boundary selection. In the selection list choose electric currents. Locate the shell thickness section in the DS text field type 400 nanometer. Click the show more options button in the model builder toolbar. In the show more options dialog box in the tree select the checkbox for the node physics advanced physics options. Click OK. In the model builder window under component 1 comp 1 electric currents a single layer ECS click current conservation 1. In the settings for current conservation locate model input section. In the ND text field, type 1.4E20. Type 1.45E20 and 1 by centimeter per cube. That is correct, 1 by per centimeter cube, yes. Locate the coordinate system selection section from the coordinate system list. Choose rotated system 2. In the model builder window, click piezoresistive material. Here in the settings window for piezoresistive material locate boundary selection section. In the selection list choose piezoresistor. In the model input section in the ND text field type 1.32E19. Bracket of 1 by centimeter cube. Locate the coordinate system selection section. From the coordinate system list, choose rotated system 2. In the physics toolbar, click adjust and choose ground. Select edge 195 only. In the physics toolbar, click adjust and choose terminal. Select edges 30 and 35 only. In the settings window for terminal, locate the terminal section. From the terminal type list, choose voltage. in V0 field type 3. In the Physics toolbar, click Adjust and choose Terminal. Select edge 20 only. In the Physics toolbar, click Adjust and choose Terminal. Select Adjust 201, 205 only. In the Model Builder window under Component 1, click Mesh 1. In the Settings window for Mesh, locate the Mesh Settings section. In the Sequence list, choose User Controlled Mesh. In the Model Builder window under Component 1, Mesh 1, click Size. In the Settings window for Size, locate the Element Size section, click Custom. Locate the element size parameter section in the maximum element size text field type 60. In the minimum element size text field type 0.5. In the Model Builder window, right click Mesh 1 and choose Size. In the Settings window for Size, locate Geometric Entity selection and choose Boundary. Now, from the selection list, choose Piezoresistor. Locate the element size section, click the custom button. Locate the element size parameter section, select the maximum element size checkbox. In the associated text field type 2, select the minimum element size checkbox. In the associated checkbox type 0.1, right click size 1 and choose duplicate. In the settings window for size, locate the geometry entity selection. In the selection list, choose connections. Locate the element size parameter section in the maximum element size text field type 6. Right click size 2 and choose duplicate. In the settings window for size, locate geometric entity selection section. In the geometric entity level list, choose edge. In select number 74, 79, 104, 108, 111, 114, 117, 120, 123, 142, 143, 146, 146. Locate the element size parameter section. Right click. In the maximum element size type 0.4. Now in the model builder, right click free tetrahedral one and choose disable. In the mesh toolbar, click boundary and choose free triangular. In the settings window for free triangular, locate the boundary selection section. From the selection list, choose upper surface. In the mesh toolbar, click swept. Click build mesh. In the home toolbar, click equals compute. So we are going for displacement. First go to add flat group in the home toolbar. Go for 3D flat group, then rename this as displacement. Then right click displacement. And then go to surface. In the settings, go for replace expressions. Go for solid mechanics displacement. Then in the displacement, the first one solid disk magnitude. Then in right click surface one and choose deformation. And in the displacement toolbar, click plot. Then in the home toolbar, add plant group, add 3D. With this inclined shear stress. Bracket of local coordinates. Now in this, locate this plane and then right click and then choose surface. In the surface go for replacement of this one, and in this go for solid mechanics, and in solid mechanics stress tensor stress. Go to stress and then the stress tensor. In the stress tensor, choose local coordinate system. So in the local coordinates, choose solid.si12. Okay, now in the shear plane stress local coordinates toolbar, click plot. Okay, go to home tab, add 1D plot group. In this type inclined shear stress local coordinates. Now in the plot group of local coordinates, right click and then go for line graph. in the line graph selected just 16 and 213 only. Now in the settings, go for replacement of expression. In this, select solid mechanics stress. In this, select second POLR. Second POLR, stress local coordinate system. In this, choose the SI12. Okay. Now in this, click on plot. Okay. Now in the model builder results data set node. Now in this, for selection one, you have to right click on the data set and then choose duplicate. In the results toolbar of attributes, choose selection. Now in the settings of selection, locate geometry entity section and choose boundary. In the boundary selection, choose piezo resistor and zoom to selection. Now change it to current. Then go for the results of 3D plot group. Now in settings of 3D plot group, type current and voltage. And in the data section, for data is choose solution 1 of 2. Right click current and voltage and choose contour. In the settings for contour, locate expression section and type V. Locate the levels in the total level type 40. And locate coloring style and color table as thermal. And after this, reverse the color table checkbox. In the model builder, right click current and voltage, choose nano surface. In the arrow surface of settings, so choose replace expression and then go for the component one, electric currents, and followed by that single layer shell currents and charges. In this, go for ECS TJX, ECS TJX tangential current material and geometry frames. And in this, locate the coloring and styling section, select the color scale factor checkbox. And in this, type 2E-9. Now in arrow positioning section, in the number of arrows, type 3000. In locate the coloring and style section, change color to blue. Now click on plot. Now in the results, click on global evaluation. Now click on replace expression. For this, go for component one, electric currents. In this, choose terminal ECS I0_1. Now again go for add expression. Go for this same electric currents. Go for terminals. But here V_2. However, change this to minus of ECS dot of V0_3. For this, change the ECS I and for this milliampere, and then this is millivolt. So yeah, now this word is our device output. Now we are going to finish with the local expression. Click evaluate. So this is the final stuff of our experiment. In this we are able to see the counter plot of the voltage here, that is the electric potential will follow through a voltage. In fact, some of the textbooks on electromagnetism clearly mention the flow of current on the actual value of gradient caused due to the electric potential. This is the gradient of a voltage that is happening inside the piezoresistive sensor. So through the blue lines we are able to see how the gradients are going to pass through the contours that are actually being plotted for the terminal current and device output. Previously we have evaluated how the contour is going to happen. So in this we have found that we can change the number of levels of contours. We have mentioned explicitly there are 40 levels of contours. So some of the contours are visible in this diagram, but if I go for zoom extents, you will be able to see how the actual contour is spread throughout the entire piezoresistive pressure sensor. So this is a pressure sensor. So wherever there is a pressure applied, a piezoresistive material is going to deform in a particular way and create changes in resistance, and whose measurement can lead to the output that is proportional to the pressure applied. In fact, pressure sensors are used in many of the places like microphones, as well as in instead of force sensor also pressure sensors can be replaced. So there are many applications for this, and this is the main thing.